another happy United fan. Ian, thanks so much for joining us. We avoided a third consecutive defeat today. How happy are you with that win?
Yeah, delighted. Expectations were low coming into this week. Last week was a shit show. There's no other word for it. But yeah, three at the back is obviously seems to be a form that might work going forward. So yeah, I think it's a bit of a little bit of a save execution for Ollie. I don't know if he's going to be there long term. But I mean, how can't you enjoy 3-0 away? Like, what a win. Chuffed.
Would you like to see Ollie stay, or would you like to see someone else come in?
It's hard to know. Like, there's talk of bringing in, Conte's obviously the name of the street at the moment, Zidane. There's names being thrown around. I don't know if they can come in and do a better job necessarily. But like long term, like you look at the likes of Chelsea, they have Tuchel, Liverpool have Klopp, you've Guardiola at City, you've got top managers who've proven it at other clubs. And in the case of Ollie, he doesn't really have the same resume or CV as the other boys do. I don't think he's the one to take us to win in Champions League, Premier League trophies, which is at the end of the day, like the only success metric for United is trophies, like coming second. Last season was all well and good, but reality is no trophies. It you can't constitute a successful season if you're not winning trophies at the end of the day.
And last week against Liverpool, we were conceding a lot of chances, which obviously we were punished for. We weren't really pressing enough. Where do you think we sort of did a lot better today?
I think having the three boys at the back, like, I still think Harry Maguire and Lindelof are liable to make a mistake during the game. Varane definitely shored it up, and having him in the middle of that there, I think moving forward, it could be a system that works. But overall, like, I still don't think Fred McTominay are the answer, sitting in front of the back three or the back two or the back three or the back four, whatever we play with moving forward. Yeah, I still don't think it's we're good enough to beat the top teams. Even that domestically, I don't think we can still crack the top two or three with Chelsea, City, and Liverpool there. But it's progress. It's a win, as I said. City next week will be a different challenge. City obviously lost today to Palace, so maybe not in as good form as I thought they were going to be going in. But we'll see. We'll see. It's yeah, definitely a good day. We need to enjoy the good days when they happen, because these days are not as frequent as they used to be.
What did you think about the duo of Ronaldo and Cavani up front as well?
Yeah, it was weird, because when they brought Ronaldo in, like, obviously wasn't particularly needed. Like, him going to City was obviously never, like, was it about day or so where he was potentially going to City was talking to every United fan, it was a fucking nightmare. I don't know if you're allowed to curse, but apologies anyway. But yeah, like, having those two boys up front, like, it was hard to see where Cavani would factor in with Ronaldo playing, Sancho, Rashford. We've a lot of forward, like, a lot of good forward players, a lot of options, even being able to bring Rashford, Lingard off the bench. Like, we're pretty well set in that part of the field. I think moving forward, like, City next week, I'll be interested to see if he sticks with three at the back and keeps the two boys up front there. But having that dynamic where we have Bruno kind of sitting in behind and then the two boys making runs playing ahead of him, like, it might be a solution, because obviously last week was a nightmare. Like, I don't think Ronaldo has it in him at this stage to press. Cavani looks like he's willing to do a bit of grunt work despite his age. So yeah, I'm not I wouldn't be against seeing him playing up front next week against City.
And Aaron Wan-Bissaka as well, he had moments of playing really, really well today. He also was chasing Son Heung-min and managed to catch him, so he didn't get the goal. I thought he had a pretty good game.
Yeah, like, listen, going forward, he's not it. Like, it's probably unfair that he gets compared to, like, a Reece James, who obviously scored twice today. Trent, who's probably one of the best attacking fullbacks in Europe. Defensively, he's as good as both of those players, probably a little bit better. But moving forward, I think, like, you see, even saw in the Europa League final with Villarreal last year, they're happy to give him space on the ball, because he doesn't look as comfortable on the ball as the likes of Trent and Reece James, and they're the kind of guys you need to compare him to, particularly when that's the standard that you need to get to. As I said, they're the teams we're trying to be.
And great to see Rafael Varane back today as well. How much of a boost do you think he gives to Harry Maguire?
Yeah, I mean, he's been there and done it. Like, he's played alongside Sergio Ramos at Real Madrid. He has the experience. Obviously, he's won a World Cup. Like, he's a player who's used to playing at the high standard. And obviously, Harry Maguire, he looks like a different player when he plays in the Euros for England versus playing for United at times. Particularly that, I think, the Keita goal last week, or the first or second goal last week when he had the mix with Luke Shaw. Like, he can look very poor at times. But obviously, I think even at the start of the season when Varane and Maguire playing alongside each other, like, it still didn't look kind of like the finished article. But maybe having Lindelof slot in there alongside them, it could be, as I said, three at the back. It seems like it's two have worked today, but I think the real test will be City next week, Atlanta during the week as well. Like, that's where we'll see whether or not this is actually sustainable long term for it to work as a system.
Who would you like to see be given more of a chance moving forward?
Jeez.
People are saying about Donny van de Beek as well.
Yeah, like, he hasn't I don't know exactly where he could fit into the team. Like, he seems to probably play in the same position as Bruno plays, and Bruno's undroppable. Even today, he had a good game. And it's hard to remember, really, when Bruno's having a bad game, he's still capable of producing a moment where he's going to score or even get an assist. So, I don't think he's going to be able to fit into that Fred McTominay kind of double pivot there. I don't think that's his ideal position. But they did sign him with the intention of, like, they signed him for $35 million. I would be more kind of focused on Sancho, like, with the system they're playing now, where Wan-Bissaka is playing right wing back. I don't really see where he's going to fit into the overall picture. They spent 70 million on him, or 81 million euros, 70 million pounds or so. So, like, I assume they're going to play him. But if they move towards the system, like, I don't really see where he's going to slot in, unless, again, they switch back to that, like, 4-2-3-1 that they were playing previously.
Question is, would you keep the same formation and team? We've got Man City next weekend, so would you keep the same?
Yeah, I mean, like, coming into this week, I would have expected City to hockey Palace 5-0 at home, and banging in goals left, right and centre. And I'm not going to lie, coming in today, I wasn't terribly confident, even though Spurs aren't really firing on all cylinders at the moment. I feel like he probably will. Would I keep it? Probably, I would. Like, the issue, I think, with City is that, like, they don't really play... They'll probably play Foden in a false nine position. Like, so the three boys are going to be at the back. They're not really marking anyone, so they might get a little bit lost. But, like, I wouldn't be against it. Like, we can only kind of go off what we've seen recently, or just that game just there. And, like, getting a clean sheet was obviously massive for us. We don't get many of those these days. It's usually a mistake in us. So, yeah, I would be shocked if we didn't go into City again with three at the back, playing maybe not the same exact team, but playing that same shape, maybe one or two small changes made. I think Rashford could potentially come in as well and make a bit of a difference.
Absolutely. Well, we move to fifth now, so enjoy the win, and thanks for talking to us.
Lovely.
Thank you.